Good morning, young scientists and engineers from Newport News Public Schools. Welcome to Thomas Jefferson National Accelerator Facility. Today, you will join an elite group of STEM professionals who travel from all over the globe to visit and work at Jefferson Lab. Jefferson Lab is a world-leading nuclear physics research facility located right here in Newport News. The lab's unique mission is to help us better understand the universe by studying the smallest particles of matter and the forces that hold them together. All matter, solids, liquids, and gases are made of combinations of these particles called atoms. Even humans, like you and me, are made of atoms. Atoms are so small they cannot be seen with our eyes alone. A single speck of dust is made up from about 3 trillion atoms. To learn about the particles that make up these atoms, scientists conduct experiments at Jefferson Lab. We have two machines that act like giant microscopes and allow scientists to view an atom and things a million times smaller than an atom. They are the Continuous Electron Beam Accelerator Facility, or CBAF, and the Low Energy Recirculator Facility, or LERF for short. This may sound like science fiction, but it's the real deal. These machines allow scientists to study the individual parts that make up an atom. These subatomic particles have really fun names, like quarks and gluons. Before we explore how the LERF works, we need to review some important findings from your investigations. You probably discovered that light is a form of energy that travels very fast and in straight paths. What did you observe when the white light passed through a prism? Go ahead, shout it out. That's right, it's broken down into the colors of the rainbow. You also learned that light behaves differently when passing through different objects, and that light is reflected when it hits a shiny surface. Now that we have some background knowledge, we're ready to learn more about the Low Energy Recirculator Facility. It is located in a large building and is shaped like a small racetrack. It works by propelling an electron beam traveling close to the speed of light that is guided through a series of magnets called a wiggler or undulator. This process forces the energized electrons to give off some of their energy in the form of photons, or light. The photons are directed at a target. When the photons strike the target, the interactions between the target and the photon are recorded and studied. By studying the building blocks of matter, scientists can help find ways to improve healthcare, make new and stronger materials, and create sustainable energy for a cleaner environment. Now it's time for you to use what you have learned about light and how it travels to complete an engineering design challenge simulating the work some STEM experts are doing at Jefferson Lab. Good luck, Newport News 4th and 5th grade scientists. I know you can do it.